There were a lot of independent dealers in Miami at the time. There were Cubans, there were other Colombians, but she trafficked cocaine in such large volumes that many of the independent dealers couldn't compete with Griselda Blanco. She had a penthouse on Biscayne Bay. She had a Miami Beach estate, you know, it was a palace. She had expensive European cars, convertible Rolls Royce automobiles, and she had lavish A-list parties at her mansion. They were parties like none other.
All the drug dealers hang out there.
All the big names in the cocaine business at that time, or the up-and-coming traffickers, Pablo Escobar, Carlos Slater, those guys, they attended the Godmother's functions, and there would be scantily clad women walking around, some women completely nude, servicing the needs of the guests. In the Godmother's foyer at her palace, at her Miami Beach mansion, there was a bronze sculpture of her, right down to the smirk. And like when all these big-name traffickers, every time they came to visit with the Godmother, they would always rub the statue for good luck. So whatever it was the Godmother had, hopefully would rub off on them. Even Pablo Escobar, every time he would come visit the Godmother, he would always rub her sculpture. And this was Pablo Escobar. Pablo Escobar was Griselda's protege. In the very beginning, he was a car thief in Envigado, Colombia. Griselda is the one who actually introduced Pablo Escobar to cocaine dealing. She put him in business, and he was loyal to her for many years.